We are a family of five, stepping out of our everyday busy lives to explore the world. We retired early, started homeschooling, and packed our bags. Join us on this wild adventure. We are the Traversing Family.
All right, good morning from Cameron Highlands. It's travel day number 4 for us. And today, we're taxi and training to, where are we going, Elliot?
Penang.
So Jen did all the logistics planning for us to figure out how in the world we were gonna get from Cameron Highlands, which is not so well connected, to Penang, an island. There are bridges to get there, but anyways, I'll let Jen talk about how we got between the two places.
We chose to take a taxi from Cameron Highlands to Pempar to catch a train. I'll leave the link below of the train company that we used in order to get our train. Then we took our train all the way over to Butterworth, where we caught a ferry over to Penang. Now you can buy your tickets for the ferry right there at the ferry terminal. Very easy to do. Short ferry ride just to get there.
Yeah, the ferries run, it seemed like every 20 minutes or so. So pretty quick to get across. And then once you're on the other side in Penang City, on the island of Penang, you can get a cab or take the city bus. City buses there actually were pretty well connected. Usually about every 20 minutes a bus was running to almost anywhere on the island, except for a few places kind of off the beaten path. So we originally decided that we wanted to go to Penang because we love Penang curry. And of course we're gonna go to an island named Penang, see if we can get some of that curry. Unfortunately, we actually didn't find that much Penang curry on the island of Penang, but we did find some great beaches, and we stayed on Batu Ferengi Beach, which is on the west side of the island. So lots of great sunsets over there from that side, lots of resorts and lots of water and beach activities, and the kids and us had a great time just hanging out there.
The sand was nice and soft and the water wasn't too cold for our kids to play hours on end.
One day we loaded up our backpacks and headed down to Penang National Park. Now we decided to do the Turtle Beach hike, and once you get to the national park entrance, you can pay your entrance fee and also set up your logistics for the day. So if you're going to take a boat, some of the beaches can be reached by boat, you don't even have to hike. Or like we chose to hike one way to Turtle Beach and then take the boat back.
It was about a 4.5 kilometer hike, and our littlest, who's 4 years old, hiked the whole thing herself. It took about 2.5 hours for us to get to Turtle Beach, and then we spent another half hour or so, which probably wasn't enough time, before we caught our boat all the way back to our starting point.
Turtle Beach. The reason it's called Turtle Beach is because a lot of turtles lay their eggs there, and there's a turtle conservation center there. So you can go visit some baby turtles, see some turtle nesting sites, and learn all about what the people of Malaysia are doing to try to protect the turtles.
The hike to Turtle Beach was awesome because I love to see local people helping the turtles out.
right, so we are at the Batu Ferengi Food Center, and I got some, I gotta read the sign because I can't pronounce it otherwise. Char Kway Teow. It looks really good. And I figured out how to use chopsticks again. It's been a while. It's good.
Today we're visiting the tropical fruit farm, and we're gonna learn about the hundreds of different fruits, like the pineapple above
us. Oh, that looks yum, huh?
Yeah.
Having the opportunity to walk around such a large area with so many diverse tropical fruits was a great opportunity for our kids to learn about things that they see in a grocery store but have never actually seen the plant or the bark of a cinnamon tree. They've tasted cinnamon, but they've never actually seen the bark. Great opportunity and learning experience for them.
Plus, you know, it can't all be fun and games. I mean, we are homeschooling or world schooling our kids while we're out here. So we have to find educational opportunities. And what a better thing than take them to the tropical fruit farm to learn about all kinds of different fruits that we've never seen or tasted before. All right, so we have our fruit trays now at the tropical fruit farm, and we get to try all these cool new kinds of fruit, like dragon fruit, pomelo, passion fruit. I don't even know what half this stuff is.
Neither do I.
A water apple. It's pretty good, though.
Here's a water apple.
It is.
Yeah. Well, it's
fine. We just learned about a bunch of these now. We're going to eat them.
Yes, we are.
So, dig in, huh?
It tastes like...
No, what? Is that good berry. Seeds? Berry. Can you eat berry. These seeds? Can you eat these seeds?
Yes, you can.
Like what?
All the seeds you can eat.
It's like very sour.
Like a lemon.
Oh, the monkeys. We love seeing the monkeys jumping from one tree to the next. Penang has a very large population of monkeys right there in the city, and right outside of our hotel room, we're able to watch the monkeys in the morning or in the evening as they gathered fruits and just monkeyed around.
Or we watched the mom monkeys jump from tree to tree with a baby hanging off their chest. Looked a little sporty. Babies never fell off though.
Thankfully.
Yeah.
All right, we got the Monkey Olympics going on right now. See if I can catch it. A couple have already jumped across this creek here.
Okay.
Here they go. Oh. Yeah.
Look at that.
So once again, we find ourselves in another food center, this time at the Jetty Food Center in Penang. We love these food centers because it's basically a food court. You go order your food, they bring it to your table. They have all kinds of cool stuff, so you can find something for the whole family. And Elliot, what do you have over there?
Fried corn. Good.
And she's got sweet potatoes.
So no visit to Penang is complete without visiting downtown Penang City itself, the historical district. There's lots of really cool buildings down there, most notably the clan jetties. And these are where clans of fishermen basically built their houses on stilts over the water and connected them all together. And now they're just little villages built out over the water there. And it's really fun to explore and check out the architecture.
And it's quite amazing that so many homes are in this area, this small little village, and this is where they lived, and the water was right there.
My favorite in Penang was the jetties, because there were lots and lots of colors on the houses, and I really liked it.
We spent 7 days in Penang and definitely could have spent longer than just a week.
Yeah, you could spend probably 2 weeks there. It's still, you wouldn't run out of things to do. There's so many activities and attractions on the island of Penang. So definitely add it to your list. It's a great place to visit. We enjoyed it.
Thank you. Thanks for watching, and thank you for your kind words and your support. If you haven't already, go ahead and click the subscribe button or give us a thumbs up. And next time, don't forget to watch
where we find a way to get from Penang to Koh Lanta to Thailand, despite the fact that all the ferries are canceled these days since COVID. There is a way, however, and we'll show you.
Stay tuned.
See you next time. Thanks, guys.
Bye.